Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. Yesterday, we started with the performance appraisal, the topic performance appraisal, wherein we studied, we discussed the definition of performance appraisal, the meaning, and the various objectives and purpose of the performance appraisal. Today, the plan of action for this class is process of performance appraisal. What are the various steps that are involved in the performance appraisal? And what are the various factors to be considered, or issues or elements to be considered while designing any appraisal system? Okay. So for the first one, process, there is a block diagram. Okay, step by step procedure. First, I'll draw the block diagram and then I shall explain. So appraisal process, it starts with the very first step is to lay out the objectives of performance appraisal. Okay, so in this class I'll be using the abbreviation PA for the performance appraisal. Instead of writing performance appraisal every time, I'll be writing as PA. So the next step is establish job expectations. Next, design an appraisal program. Next step is appraise performance next performance interview. Next, archive performance data, or you can put it as appraisal data. And next step is use of appraisal data for various purposes. Here, I will interview. And okay, so this is a block diagram or various steps that are involved in the appraisal process. First of all, objectives of the performance appraisal. So yesterday we have studied four different types of appraisal, like with respect to the employee, with respect to the employer, with respect to the organization, with respect to the communication. Okay, so what type of objectives you are going to set for the performance appraisal? Okay, are you concentrated, means it simply means that which areas you are concentrating on. Whether it is only the employee performance on the job, or the job behavior of the employee, or his interpersonal factors, or whether are you going to evaluate the alignment of the personal goals to the organizational goals of the employee. So all these types of objectives you are going to set. See, usually what happens, most of the times, performance appraisal, many of the organizations, they fail to follow these steps or they just neglect these steps. Okay, randomly they choose something and they'll end up preparing or having a design of a performance appraisal system, and which will be very less effective. So these steps are very important. Okay, time-tested steps where every organization, they have to follow these steps to design their own performance appraisal system. Okay, so the first one, objectives. It is very important what type of organization you are having. Okay, what is more important to you as an employer? Is it just the output, or is it the welfare of the organization, welfare of the employee, or how it is? What are your moral values? What is your social responsibility? So many things. Okay, and against all those objectives, you are going to evaluate the employee. So that is, first you have to lay out or list out or just make out what are the objectives you are looking for. Next is establish job expectation. Okay, so what do you mean by job expectation? So first you are going to set the objectives. Okay, I'll just write them here. First you are going to note down the objectives, write like objective 1, objective 2, objective 3. Maybe it may be related to communication, it may be related to the organizational goals, it may be related to the output of the total output. Okay, like this. You are going to set the objectives, and next you are going to establish job expectation. So what are your objectives? What an employee has to do to achieve these objectives? Means you are setting some targets, not targets, you are setting some expectation from the employee. Okay, you are expecting employee to behave in a certain way or work in a certain way to achieve these objectives. Okay, so maybe to achieve this objective 1, the employee should behave in a certain way, should act in a certain way, should work in a certain way. So that becomes his job expectation number 1. Similarly for other objectives. Okay, like this you are going to establish job expectation. Okay, that is very important. Otherwise what happens? For example, if you don't have any particular objectives, if you skip this step, if you skip this step or fail to set out proper objectives, then how you are going to tell your employee what exactly you are expecting? Or how an employee will come to know that what he has to do? What are the goals laid for him from the organization? Okay. So these two steps, first two steps are very important, which will clearly mention or clearly address what an employee has to do with respect to his job. Okay. So next is design an appraisal program. So now in the designing the appraisal program, how you are going to design an appraisal program? What are the factors to be considered? Or what are the various issues or various elements you have to consider while doing this third step? Okay, there are various factors in this. We'll discuss elaborately then. So this design, or we can write, okay, let's put it this way. Okay, this is with respect to designing an appraisal program. What are the various factors to be considered, or elements, or what are the issues that are involved in designing the appraisal program. Let's study this or let's elaborate this and then discuss. Okay, so first let me write here issues or elements. Okay, so first of all, you are designing an appraisal system. First of all, what is needed? Whether it is a form, it has to be formal or informal. Formal versus informal. As we have gone through the definition of the appraisal system yesterday in the previous class, the definition says it is a systematic, periodic and impartial evaluation of the employee's performance. So we started with the word systematic. Systematic is nothing but formal. Informal, you cannot document it properly. There is no uniformity. Okay, people tend to get impartial if we follow the informal system. A manager cannot come to the shop floor and tell, okay, this person is very good, this employee works very good, I'm going to promote him. He cannot tell that. He needs to have the documents or performance. Okay, so it is always formal. Formal is there are certain people who are involved in the evaluation process and there are certain things which are to be evaluated. Okay, certain things which has to be communicated to the employee. So all the systematic design we can get it from only formal design. So this is the first element to be considered in designing the performance appraisal system. Formal versus informal. In that we are choosing the formal one. So next, whose performance? Second one, whose performance? Okay, if I ask you whose performance you are going to evaluate, you can simply say, obviously it is employee. Okay, employee, what type of employees? Whether it's employee as an individual or work group or a team, how you are going to appraise them or whose performance you are going to assess? Employee, when we say as an individual, work group or the team, whose performance you are going to evaluate. Okay, you want to design a appraisal system for an individual. It will be different. It will have different methods. It will have different implications. Okay, the entire procedure will be different. And if it is a work group who are working in a certain area, certain project, similarly with the team, okay, a team of managers, a team of shop floor workers, a team of supervisors, okay. When you choose what type of employee, what category of employee you are going to evaluate, obviously the designing of the appraisal system changes. So you must know, or you must very well in hand, you should decide whom you are designing the system. Okay, next. Once you decide this, next, who are the raters? Who are the raters? Okay, assume or imagine you want to design an appraisal system for individual employee as an individual, then who has to evaluate them? Here raters are nothing but no one but evaluators. Who is going to evaluate them. Okay, who is going to rate them? So if you take an example of me as a teacher, you are designing a appraisal system for me to evaluate my performance. So who will be the raters for me, different raters for me? Obviously, first raters will be you guys, that is students. You all of you are asked to give the feedback at the end of every semester, right? You will be given a certain questionnaire and there will be options, satisfactory, very satisfactory, average, like that. You fill that feedback form, right? So that you guys play the role of raters, evaluators. You are evaluating my performance as a teacher. What are my, how is my teaching? How is my performance? You are going to rate me. You are going to evaluate me. So you are one set of raters. Right. To put it in a corporate term, I'll put it as clients. Okay. And who else can evaluate my performance? Here, if you consider this any educational institution, the major job of the teacher is, major part is to teach in the class, to impart the knowledge. Along with that, there are so many things. Okay. We will be working on certain projects. We will be dealing with some industries outside. Okay, and there are so many administrative work we are doing. Okay, so all these things. So who else can evaluate me? The HOD, right? HOD, and who else? My peers, my subordinates. They also can evaluate my performance. Okay. So subordinates. Supervisor, right? So who else? Did I leave anybody else who can evaluate my performance? Right, one more. Can I self-evaluate my performance? Yes, I can, right? So that is called as self-appraisal, oneself. So these are the set of raters who are going to evaluate my performance. Similarly, for any employee, irrespective of the various organizations, be it an IT industry or non-IT industry, or an educational institute, or any service industry like your hotel, your bank, hospitals, if you take any example, all of the employees, everybody has a certain set of evaluators or raters. Okay, clients, subordinates, or peers. You might have heard the word peer review, right? Your subordinates, peers, your supervisors or superiors. Here, superior, my superior is the head of the department, right? And self-appraisal. These are the set of the raters. And while designing this, you have to decide whom you are going to ask to evaluate a certain employee. Okay. For a manager, who will be evaluating his performance? Most of the times it is clients. Next. For the shop floor workers, usually his subordinates and his supervisor, okay, or foreman will be evaluating his performance. Right? Like that, every employee have a set of raters and you have to choose whom you are going to pick as raters. You have to be very clear with this point. Okay. So next, So next is, what methods you are going to use? Okay, there are various methods, okay, which we will be studying or discussing in detail in the coming classes. There are various methods, traditional methods and modern methods, right? So you have to choose what methods you are going to apply or use for the to design your appraisal system, okay, which is well suitable or which is which will suit the type of raters you have chosen or which will be helpful in assessing which group of employees. Okay, so you have to carefully choose. Okay, and one more thing here, these methods, all these methods are cost incurring. Okay, so based on that, you have to choose an effective, cost effective and time effective. Which method is going to consume less time or effective time? It shouldn't happen like that. The one method you choose and it is occurring so much of cost to you, to the organization, as well as it is consuming more time. Okay, such methods you should usually avoid. Okay, so that's why I told it should be cost effective and time effective. Cost effective and time effective. So carefully you have to choose which methods you are going to use. Okay, so next, when to evaluate. When to evaluate. See here, again, let's just memorize or recall the definition of the performance appraisal. It says systematic and periodic. Periodic is there has to be certain timeline when you are going to evaluate the performances of various employees. Can you evaluate an employee in the last month of the financial year, only in just 1 month, or his performance should be evaluated for the entire year or certain timeline like 3 months, 4 months? Okay, how you are, based on your objectives. Okay, for example, one of your objective is interpersonal skills or interpersonal behavior or interpersonal communication. Okay, you want to evaluate this objective or your objective of the performance appraisal. You are designing a performance appraisal system to check or to evaluate or to know how the employee behaves with his subordinates, how the employee behaves with his juniors, seniors, managers, okay, with his interpersonal skills. Okay, so when you have this objective, you cannot evaluate his performance in the last month or in only 1 day. Okay, he has to be evaluated for the entire year. Okay, entire year in the sense he should be on a watch. How his behavior with his different work groups. Okay, and if a person is working on a certain project, you want to evaluate his performance on the basis of the output. Okay, that time you can consider the project timeline. Like that, when to evaluate, what is the proper timing to evaluate a employee. That also you have to properly design or properly decide. So next, see these things, when to evaluate and what to evaluate. As I have told while discussing when to evaluate, those things comes under here also. what to evaluate. As I've told, whether the interpersonal behavior of the employee or the job behavior, his attitude towards the work, his attitude towards the his superiors, how he is going to behave with the juniors. Okay, what to evaluate. Whether it is just output, total output out of the job. Okay, how quickly he could complete the project, what are the skills he possesses, what are technical skills he possesses, is he utilizing all of them properly, okay, how best he could be a manager. So all those things, what to evaluate. You cannot design an appraisal system where you can evaluate all the things. Okay, you can club together various factors and design your system. Okay, so next, what problems? What problems, and last one, how to solve. Okay, once you are done with this, you should know if after the evaluation you come up with some problems, how you are going to solve them. Okay, problems in the sense the employee might be facing some problem or the rater. See, if you ask my peers, my subordinates to evaluate me, if you ask one person who doesn't share a very strong or a good relation with me in the college, then he might give a negative feedback or negative, he might evaluate me negatively. Okay, so such problems or any problem that is coming out of the employee, or if employee has any problem with the evaluator or the feedback or the appraisal. Okay, so all those problems, what problems are expected and how to solve them. Okay, so that also should be considered while designing your appraisal system. Okay, so this is very important issues to be or elements to be considered while designing the appraisal system. Okay, you cannot just underrate any of these, any of the factors. You should choose wisely. Okay, so next is, next step, appraise the performance. So now you have laid the various objectives for the evaluation process. Next, you have established the job expectations. You have set the expectation for the employee, from the employee what he has to do. Next, you have designed your appraisal system. So what is next? Next is appraise the performance. Means you have chosen the employees, you have chosen the raters, you have chosen the evaluators, you have chosen the methods, you have given, you have made all the documents ready. Now you have to conduct the performance appraisal. Okay, once it is done, next is performance interview. Okay, so this is again very important step. So once the everywhere, in most of the organizations, when the performance appraisal is done, performance appraisal, there will be an interview conducted. That is called as performance interview. Okay, where the one who is evaluating or the manager will talk to the employee one-to-one about his performance. Okay, you have got the good feedback, or your evaluation is very, your performance is very well, and if there are any negative comments or if there are any negative parameters, or if the employee is facing any problem, he'll kind of counsel him, he'll just explain him or just discuss the points that are listed in his performance appraisal document. Okay, and will briefly discuss what needs to be done. Okay. And this data, they are going to use it in the promotions, demotions, salary hikes, okay, transfers, all those things. So to do all that, we have to archive the appraisal data. That is, we have to save the data, all the performance appraisal data of all the employees. Okay, which contains all the details, who has evaluated the which employee and what methods they have followed. There are various methods. Most of the methods, they come with a document. Okay, all those documents like your checklist, all those things, or questionnaire. Okay, so all those things, feedback forms, all those things have to be archived. And at the end, you are going to use this appraisal data for various purposes. Here, purposes would be your promotion or demotion, transfers, compensation, salary hike, or perks. Okay, so based on the data, if an employee has and also awards and rewards, okay, if an employee has done exceedingly well, then he'll be given the promotion or salary will be hiked or some awards will be given, awards and incentives. Okay, and also termination. If an employee poses negative feedback or his performance appraisal comes to be very negative, then if they think he is unfit for the job, then they can terminate the employee. Okay, so all the things are the, they can use the appraisal data to all these things. Okay. So here, performance interview to establish job expectation. I have drawn a arrow here. Means after the interview, if they found that what they are expecting out of that one particular employee is not correct. For example, one employee is working on a project and he has not done so good. Okay. His performance evaluation not so good. It comes to be negative. Then they might redo the job expectation for him. Might be he's very good at some other project, some other skill, some other technology. Okay. That time they can change the job. They can review their or they can re-establish their job expectation out of one particular employee. Okay. Similarly here, after this here, and consider like this. Here, performance management. I have just rubbed this off. I'll write it here again. Performance management. So with this data, we are going to manage the performance of each individual or each employee. Okay, so hope you have understood this properly. Various steps involved in the performance appraisal, and in that, designing the appraisal system or appraisal program, very important. Different elements that are included in this. Okay, so next, Next, there is something called as 360 degree appraisal. So here, what is the meaning of this? When an employee or he is rated by various people, not just, it's not like you are a one only to evaluate my performance, the students evaluating the performance of the teacher, not just that, but also everybody involved with my work, my HOD, my peers, principal, everybody is going to evaluate me. Okay, that is called as 360 degree appraisal. To be precise, an employee's performance is rated by superiors, peers, subordinates and clients. Okay, four set of people are going to evaluate my performance. Okay, it is first developed and used by General Electric in 1992, and now the entire world, everywhere they are using this. So who all are involved in this? Superiors, subordinates, peers and clients. So all of them are going to evaluate the performance of the employee, then it is called as 360 degree appraisal. It is first used by General Electric in 1992. Also, we can add one more point here, that is self-appraisal. Okay. So what are the implications of this, or what is the need to use this type of performance appraisal? Okay. So it turns out to be very effective because you will have a proper picture of employees' performance with respect to various factors that are happening in the organization. Not just how he is working or how he is working on his machine, or not just how he is behaving with his clients, or not just how he is with his superiors. The overall performance, the overall behavior of the employee can be evaluated with the help of this method. Okay, that's why this seems to be very effective, but also it is time consuming and it incurs some cost. Okay, it is not very cost effective, but you can get the total clear picture about the employee. Okay. So next is various different methods of appraisal, that is traditional methods and modern methods, that we shall study in the next class. I hope till 360 degree appraisal, the concepts are clear to you. Okay, thank you.